Okay, so last year I got the idea of, well, I was wondering if anybody had had built an R2 unit from 3D printing. And so, you know, I went on the internet, and of course, like 100,000 people have already done this. So I was like, all right, cool. I've been wanting a 3D printer for a while, for years now, but every time I looked into them, I don't know, I just wasn't convinced with the quality of the things that were coming out, and a lot of the machines, you know, just look like science projects, you know, duct taped together that you'd have to maintain. So I kept putting it off. And finally last year, towards the end of the year, it was a crazy year. I should have done this in the beginning of the year, because then, you know, with the pandemic and everything, I would have had something to do. But I got the idea, well, you know what, let me see what's out there. And I started looking around. I was like, wow, you know, some of these printers are starting to look pretty decent. And the learning curve doesn't seem to be too bad. So I did some research and decided on a Prusa Mark III or MK3, whatever they're called, Plus, whatever. And I went with that one just because it had pretty good reviews. I wanted to go with something more quality. I didn't want to spend too much money, but I also didn't want to go too cheap where it's constantly something. I mean, I was looking at the qualities, but a lot of, at the point when I was looking at them, it was like, oh, you should get this quality and then spend, you know, this many hundreds of dollars to make it great. And I was like, okay, well, you know, why not just get a printer that's already set ready to go? So I got the Prusa. And I opted for the kit because I figured if I'm going to have to do any maintenance on this thing, I should know how it gets, you know, put together so I could take it apart and, you know, get in there. So that took me about, I think it was 18 hours to build over the span of 2 days. You know, I just took my time and came out pretty good. And I've been pretty happy with it. Haven't had any issues. So then I started researching R2 astromech droids. So I went to the astromech forum and spent like a few months just, you know, just taking everything in and learning all the lingo and stuff. And around December, I think, I ordered the printer. I got it in February. And then I started printing R2. And the... my taste in Star Wars is pretty narrow. I like, you know, the original trilogy just fine, but my main, I collect figures. You could check out one of my videos. I'll put the link up here in a second. I collect video or vintage Kenner Star Wars, but my main focus is just the 77 movie. I'm not really into Empire or Jedi, and definitely not into the new stuff. So my focus has always been the original Star Wars. So that was the basis for the R2 unit. I was thinking about going with all the bells and whistles, and, you know, people do all kinds of things with the panels and this and that. So I figured, well, you know what, I'm just gonna go with whatever I've seen done in the original movie, which isn't much. And obviously lights, which I have here, and maybe I'll animate the panels. I'm not sure, because I kind of like how some of the guys do the panel animations when they open up and stuff. But we'll see. I'm not there yet. So I think I started printing in April of this year, and I got all the dome parts. I started with the dome first because I figured if it becomes such a difficult project that, you know, I can't even finish it, at least, you know, the full body, at least I can try to finish the dome and I'll have a pretty cool little piece. But so I started with the rings, the two rings that support the Lacey's and Susan and attach the dome to the body. Figuring I could use it kind of like as a stand when I'm working on the dome. So I printed those out. I'm still a little paranoid about letting the printer print overnight without me being around. So luckily, my job with the pandemic going on, I work 1 week at home and 1 week in the office. So the weeks that I was at home, I would just, you know, fire up the printer and maybe get two pieces of the ring done a day. So it took the lower and top ring took about 2 weeks of printing time, and then the panels took another week. Actually, the panels I think took 3 or 4 days, and then all the dome parts, all the sides, that took about a month. So all in all, I think it was like about a month and a half of printing, and everything came out pretty good. Along the way, I also decided that I didn't want to deal with certain things, like for instance these lights. I could probably I'm capable of soldering all this stuff together, but I wanted to make this project fun and easy, and also it's a project that I'm gonna be doing for a long time, so this is gonna take me, like, you know, maybe a couple years to actually finish. The dome I'm hoping to finish next year, and then the body we'll see, because I'm not sure if I'm gonna go 3D printing on the body. At least the legs I might go wood, but we'll see. But I wanted this to be something that, you know, I just kind of tackle when I have some time. So I didn't want to bog myself down with learning too many things. I'm already have to learn the ins and outs of 3D printing. And then, you know, I could solder all these guys together, but then I'd have to learn some Arduino programming, and my eyesight's going, you know, it's like, I can't, it's hard, like, to, you know, I gotta take my glasses off just to see all these, like, fine little points. So I figured I'm gonna put some money into getting prefabricated stuff. So I got some stuff from the astromech.net forum. I got this kit already wired for me, ready to go. I got a radar lens that you could actually print too, but you would have to spend some time cleaning it up, so you get rid of the lines, the layer lines. I got these cabochons for the holo projectors. So again, you can print this, but I didn't want to kind of mess with trying to clean it up, make it look nice. And this just fits in there, and once it's lit up and everything, it's gonna look cool. So that's a shortcut. I got some more cabochons for the buttons on the side of the dome. There's these two buttons that you can also print, but I didn't like how they looked, so I decided to just use these, and I'm just gonna paint them, and I think they'll look fine. So I've put a bit of money into this project. You know, aside from the printer, so there's certain things I don't consider part of the project because I'm going to use, you know, for other things, like the printer. Even though the main reason was to build the astromech droid, you know, I can use it for other things, like
this cool toothpick holder
or this pistachio nut cracker. Orange peeler, an owl napkin dispenser, toothpaste tube squeezer, get your money's worth, a benchy. So you know, getting this pre-wired for me was a bit of an expense. I think this was like $10, the eye for the radar eye, or the lens for the radar eye. I got a bag of these, and I think it was like $5 with different sizes. You could get this off Amazon. I didn't want to go overboard too quickly, since this is going to be a project that kind of goes through a few years. I kind of wanted to budget out, you know, like I didn't want to spend more than a certain amount of money a year on it. Okay, so I started in April, and I've gotten to the point where I have the dome pretty much glued together, and I've started filling and sanding, which takes pretty much, you know, the majority of your time making one of these guys. You know, trying to get all the layer lines out and the seams and, you know, all that stuff. I started in April. I think I stopped about a month in because it got really too hot to be in the garage. It was like, you know, 100 and something inside the garage. So I waited till it got cooled off. And we're in November now. So now I'm starting up again. And here's the progress I've made on the dome. Okay, so here's the dome. I'm done with sanding the seams, at least. There's a couple spots I got marked over here with X's that I just need to come back. There's a little, you can feel a little something there and a little something there that I gotta fix. But for the most part, the main part of the dome is pretty smooth. I don't feel any seams, so I think once I start primering it, you won't see these lines won't pick up. And then I got to come in here and start cleaning this up. And up here. And then once I'm there, I'm going to start cleaning all these panel sections that got a little mucked up when I was filling, like right here. So I just have to come in and clean that up. And then I'll start the panels. And I already have them all printed. I just need to go in and start smoothing them out. And from there, we'll see where this takes me. So I expect sometime in, hopefully by next April, to have this at least primered and ready for paint. And I'm not sure how I'm gonna paint it. I've been looking at some rub and buff stuff that looks pretty good. I mean, some guys get really, like, you know, picky about it, but I'm liking how the rub and buff stuff looks because it kind of resembles the aluminum a bit. And if you look at a lot of the footage of R2 in the first movie, the rub and buff kind of matches kind of the crappiness of the finish that's in that movie. There's a few different domes that they used, but there's a lot of, like, really crappy work on it that I guess when, you know, in 77, you didn't notice because of the film. But now with, you know, Blu-ray and whatnot, and you being able to have the movies at your home and pressing pause and, you know, like, really getting in there to check out, you could see, like, wow, that's really crappy. But it never really showed up or translated when you're watching the film. And when you're just watching casually, you know, from yourself, you don't really notice all that stuff. But so at least that gives me like a basis for a crappy job, right? So, hey, it looks like the movie, sort of. So we'll see. We'll see how this comes out. And hopefully, everything will come out pretty decently. I'm using PTG because I live in Southern California. It gets pretty hot. And I heard that PLA has problems with heat, so PTG was a little more just robust, I guess, when it comes to heat. I don't plan to take this guy anywhere, so he's just going to live in my office amongst my display. The next video will probably be sometime next year, so this is just, again, just a documentation of my project. It's not really a how-to, so... but hey, man, if I can do this, you can do it. So there's a lot of cool dudes out there doing really great work. By the way, I'm using the Mr. Bradley, I think is his name, 3D files I got from his Patreon. And he's got a bunch of other droids in there, too. This is the only one I plan on building. If it goes well, maybe I'll do an R5-D4, because I really like that droid. At least the dome. And I'm kind of intrigued on the chopper. He's got files for the chopper droid from Rebels. It looks pretty neat, but I don't know. We'll see. I don't even think I really have space for this guy, but I'll make some space. So there it is. I'll probably see you guys next year with a little bit more done. Hopefully painted, panels installed, and then we'll go from there with the electronics and see where that takes us. See ya!